guys. Mom, Vernon, Kid here, back again. Welcome back to Indie Spotlight Showcase. Yeah. As you all know me, guys, as you know, this is the segment where I put the spotlight on an indie comic, a comic book that is, well, it's indie, whether it's big or small. I put the spotlight on them. And today, guys, we're going to take a look at a series that came out back in, I believe it was 2009, ran from 2009 to 2014. It was a 12-part maxi series. I got this from MegaCon Orlando this year, and it's called The Mighty by Peter J. Tomasi, Keith Champagne, artwork by Chris Somnes in this as well. I purchased this at MegaCon Orlando and even got it signed by my friend Peter Tomasi. He was there. I've met Peter Tomasi 4 times. I've met the man, and every time we meet, we just conversate. It's not even just about comics. It's just, we're just talking. Just like, how's everything going with you? How's your mom doing? You know, he was telling me about his mom once before, and she's still living up in New York. He's like, yeah, she's still there. I'm like, it's good to know. But having said that, let's get into what did I think about this. Okay, so The Mighty here is a story that's set in modern time. It is a very thick, because this is the whole series, 12 series, and the only superhero in this world is known as Alpha One. And at first, nobody really knows where he comes from. There's all these different cases of, well, he's from Earth, but he got his powers through when he was in the 50s, basically implying that during the whole atomic bombing, you know, events, he was involved with one of them and he was bombarded with atomic radiation and they thought he was dead because he was in the Navy. Unfortunately, he came back out of the water. He was completely fine. That's one of the stories they tell him. But his name is Alpha One, and you can see him on a cover, but he's kind of not what you think he is. Now, Alpha One is kind of in, he stays in contact with, like, the chief of police. There's this police force that he is, like, in cahoots with. Basically, their commissioner or so gets branded with his insignia, that big A that you see here, in their hand. And it's also a means for them to keep in contact with Alpha One. And over time, you also get to see that each commissioner that comes, they either die, or most of them have died. Like 50% of them have died, and there's all these different reasons of why. Enter Gabriel Cole, who is in leagues to becoming the new commissioner of the police force, who will be in cahoots with Alpha One. And Alpha One comes off like Superman, as he has like Superman powers. He's like a Superman clone, you know, and he seems to be very legit and very kind-hearted, you know. Good evening, citizen. You know, he talks like that retro-like talk of superheroes. But over time, you start to see certain things are changing for Gabriel. It's putting a lot of damper on his love life and his wife and things like that. Enter an unknown aspect that seems to know the situation that Gabriel's in. And it's a former commissioner who has been in hiding over time. And he breaks it down that don't trust Alpha. He's not what he seems to be. He is more than meets the eye, in a sense. He's a threat. He is he's not what he seems to be. He's a wolf. I hate to use that, but he's a wolf in sheep's clothing. And Gabriel starts to dig deeper into Alpha. Like, they become friends, but he starts to dig into him as well. It's like, okay, where are you from? Everything like that. How did you get your powers? And we also get to see that there are some commissioners that are leading the sweet life because they are somewhat in cahoots. They kept their mouth shut of things they found because of Alpha. But we do find out that Alpha is not what he seems to be. He is an alien who came to Earth centuries ago. Like, when they show him, he landed on Earth during the Revolutionary War. And when the Redcoats saw him, I believe the Redcoats and the Patriots saw him, they shoot at him. And he finds that to be totally unacceptable. So his mind, he's going to change human life into what he feels it should be. So he's been killing people and bringing them back to life, experimenting on people, humans, for centuries. And when Cole finds out, he takes it to the extreme. Now, you got to remember, he is the only superhero. Nobody really knows how to really deal with this guy. However, the way Cole Gabriel deals with Alpha was genius. I was like, wow, that's really interesting. I won't ruin it what it is, but it was really good. The pacing of this was really good. Peter Tomasi takes you on a trip of, okay, should we trust this gentleman? Should we trust this hero? Because he's the only hero in the world. He's like a 40-pound, a 40-ton elephant. And how do we stop a 40-ton elephant as human? That's the way I look at it. It's like, what if you saw a huge... Okay, let's say if we really saw a megalodon in the water coming right for us. What are we going to do? That's kind of how you look at Alpha. Chris Somney's artwork is really good. I've always liked Chris Somney's artwork. It was really good. They called this an instant classic. It was. It was really good. I really enjoyed it. The pacing, the dialogue, the twists and turns, everything. And it just makes you wonder, like, what if Superman ended up like this? That's the one thing. Like, Superman could have been just like this, and it would have been scary. Even in a world full of other heroes, what if Superman became like Alpha here? But other than that, guys, The Mighty, this is a Dark Horse book. This was really good, and shouts out to Dark Horse, because we all know that Dark Horse has... Not Dark Horse, but this was just really good. Shouts out to Mr. Tomasi, as always, Peter. Mr. T, you did a great job with this. I really enjoyed this. You said I was going to love it. I did like it a lot. I'm looking forward to reading more stuff like this. I mean, like I said, this is about 5 years old. You know, five, depending on where you take it from. But if you're going with legitimate, it's 10 years old now. This is 10 years old. But it was good, indeed. Is it violent? Yeah, it's a little gory at times, but it's meaningful for why they did it. But yeah, this was really good. Very much enjoyed it, guys. Okay, and with that being said, guys, we're gonna end it right there. I hope you guys enjoyed this review of The Mighty on Indie Showcase. Again, I have more for you. I got some Kickstarter reward for Showcase that I want to get out. So definitely look forward to that. As always, look forward to more topics and things like that. As always, this is just me being a geek on Geek Ramble. Enter the dark side. Y'all take care.